Hey, it's me, and I am back with a Shelf of Steam episode all about books. What's new about that, you might ask? Aren't they all about books? And they are. My series is all about books and writing, but I'm thinking specifically today about the physical aspect of books. I read probably 90% of what I read these days on an e-reader. But obviously over the years, I have collected a lot of physical books. My house is full of bookshelves, like the floor-to-ceiling built-in bookshelves in my bedroom behind me here. The fact that I read e-books now is not because I don't love physical books, it's because I have too many physical books and they're taking over the house. So I thought I would take a few minutes to take you on a little tour of my bookshelves, show you some of my books, and also make a little offer about an upcoming video. One of the things that I really do love and kind of miss about the era when I read a lot of physical paperbacks is the worn look that the backs of your favorite paperbacks get. Like, that is a wonderful thing to me. To pick out a book like, Dorothy Sayers' Gaudy Night that I've read so many times and just see how worn the spine looks. This fantasy series by Stephen Donaldson. This one has been read so many times, it's physically fallen apart. I love that. There's a lot of fantasy in this section generally. Some Guy Gavriel Kay. This whole shelf is almost all Robin Hobb. We got the Stephen Donaldsons down here. But then you got, like, randomly a bunch of Maeve Binchys because they just happen to fit on the shelf. I've got a whole section here that came from either my parents' or my Aunt Gertie's house, some from both, of my own favorite books from childhood and young adulthood, including, like, this random selection. I don't think I have a full set of anything, but of old L.M. Montgomery books, including this copy of Rilla of Ingleside, read so many times that, again, not only has it fallen apart, but the first 30 pages are stuck inside because they become detached. This one had a really nice cover on it, but that was lost long ago. Then you have shelves like these. I'm being really honest with you, a lot of my shelves are cluttery. A lot of them have random stuff stuck up on them that has nothing to do with books. These two shelves over my computer desk, very random assortment of some of my books, some of Jason's books, just things that happen to fit and be stuck up there. And then some really unexpected things like this old novel called Corn in Egypt, which used to be out at Aunt Gertie's house when I was growing up. I read it when I was in my teens. And inexplicably, it goes on the shelf right next to Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency. Great book. We've got another similarly oddly assorted shelf over here in what used to be a closet, which we turned into a little desk and bookshelf alcove. A lot of religious books, Bibles and Bible study books in this one. Some of mine, some of Jason's. Like, and this is not all of them, but a collection of C.S. Lewis paperbacks. Or Shane Claiborne's The Irresistible Revolution, a book I absolutely love, and I ask myself, why is this over here, and another book of his that I love, Jesus for President, over on that shelf? I don't know! Now we come to the bookcase that people who watch my videos are probably most familiar with seeing, because I often shoot videos from this spot, and this is the bookcase in my living room. I gave a lot of thought to what books were going to go on this bookcase, because I figure when guests come, they're sitting here in the big comfy chair, conversation gets a little boring, they turn to look at the books, and they judge me based on what they see. So the books I put here tend to be ones I think are a pretty good reflection of my taste. I also have a shelf here that is supposed to contain a complete collection of my own books, but because I keep taking current ones out if I'm doing a reading or something like that, often they're not all there. I also have some books on this shelf that are by family members and friends of mine, which I'm very proud of. Autographed copies of books like these and these by my Aunt Bernice Morgan and my friend Tina Chalk and other people like that are a really important part of my collection. A lot of these books were picked for their position on the shelf because they are serious favorites of mine from over the years, and also sometimes just their favorites and their books that look really great on the shelf. There are also a few of those old favorites that have the really worn out spines. The lower levels of this particular set of bookcases, also in the living room, got kind of filled up with box sets of DVDs, but up on the upper shelves there's still a few shelves of books. A couple of favorite series here that I've read and loved over the years. Laurie King with the Holmes Russell novels. Highly recommend those. There's a Betty Smith novel, which I thought was going to be A Tree Grows in Brooklyn, but I'm not sure what this is. This is Maggie Now, a less well-known Betty Smith novel. Virgins. Much less trashier than it looks. Actually a really good book, and I love the sequel even more, and that one I can't find. I hope it's on one of these shelves. Now, this is the part where I said there's an interactive element to this video. So if in this quick tour of my bookshelves you've seen a book that intrigues you, either because you'd like to know what it is or because it's one that you've read and you'd like to know what I think about it, just leave me a comment on YouTube or on Facebook, Twitter, or however else it is that you came to watch this video. show. And the book or books that you ask me about, that's the book or books that I will talk about in my next video. Also, I'm going to do a book giveaway. For everyone who plays along with this and posts a book that they saw on my shelves that they find intriguing, you let me know. All your names will go into a draw. Whichever name I choose, I will send you either a copy of that book you asked about, or if that's one you already own, any other book of your choice. And I hope you've enjoyed this tour of my bookshelves.